No, thank you. Sir, part B of my speech starts with direct tax, sir. Honorable Speaker, sir, our government has spearheaded radical fiscal measures to ensure that Indian economy continues to tread the path of high growth. There are times when countries are competing with each other like never before to become the most attractive destination for doing business. Therefore, to make sure that India stays globally competitive and a favored destination for investment, we took a bold historic decision of reducing the corporate tax rate for new companies in the manufacturing sector to an unprecedented level of 15%. Similarly, for the existing companies, the rate has also been brought down to 22%, which is the lowest in the world now. This will enable companies to expand their businesses and make fresh investments in the coming future. Though we will have loss of substantial revenue due to these measures in the short run, I'm certain that our economy will reap huge returns on this score in due course. So one quick verse from Raghuvamsa, written by Kalidasa. Prajanam eva bhutyartham sattabhyo balim agrahit. Prajanam eva bhutyartham sattabhyo balim agrahit. Sahasra gunam utsrashtam adatte hi rasam ravihi. Surya, the sun, collects vapor from little drops of water. He collects only from little drops of water. So does the king. They give back copiously. They collect these from the people only for their well-being. So the collection of taxes or the vapor from the water drops are only from small trickles, but they all go back to the people manifold. So the purpose of taxation and also the way in which it is done has been voiced even then. And this in Raghuvamsa refers to the Purvaja or the elders belonging to Ikshvaku dynasty, father of Ayodhyapati Rama, Dilipa, grandfather. It refers to Dilipa, the king. So in continuation of the reform measures already taken so far, the tax proposals in this budget will introduce further reforms to stimulate growth, simplify tax structure, bring ease of compliance, and reduce litigation. Personal income tax and simplification of taxation. So in the interim budget of 2019, our government exempted individuals having income up to 5 lakh of rupees from paying any income tax. Presently, an individual pays 20% on income between 5 lakh and 10 lakh and 30% on income between 10 lakh. That's the prevailing matrix. Further, currently the Income Tax Act is riddled with various exemptions and deductions which make compliance by the taxpayer and administration of Income Tax Act by the tax authorities a burdensome process. It is almost impossible for a taxpayer to comply with income tax law without taking the help from professionals. In order to provide significant relief to the individual taxpayers and to simplify the income tax law, I propose to bring a new simplified personal income tax regime wherein income tax rates will be significantly reduced for the individual taxpayers who forego certain deductions and exemptions. Under the new regime, sir, an individual shall be required to pay tax at the reduced rate of 10% for income between 5 lakhs to 7.5 lakhs against the prevailing 20%. So anyone who's earning between 5 to 7.5 lakhs, sir, today pays 20%. We are now reducing it in the new regime, which is devoid of exemptions, to 10% only. So 20% comes down to 10%. Sir, the next example. For income between 7.5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, I earlier said about 5 to 7.5, now I'm saying about 7.5 to 10 lakhs. So for income between 7.5 lakh to 10 lakh, he or she will pay at the reduced rate of 15% only against the current prevailing 20%. Sir, similarly, for the income between 10 lakhs to 12.5 lakhs, presently the tax is 30%. For income between 10 lakh to 12.5 lakh, the present prevailing rate is 30%. That is now being brought down to 20% only. Sir, the income between, I spoke about 10 to 12.5 lakhs. Now, 12.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs will be taxed. At the moment, 12.5 to 15 lakhs is taxed at 30%. Now, those earning between 12.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs will be charged at 25% only. Sir, incomes above 15 lakhs will be continued at 30%, but no exemptions at all. Those earning up to 5 lakhs shall not pay any tax either in the old regime or in the new regime. So the proposed tax structure will provide significant relief to taxpayers and more so to those in the middle class. I just want to very clearly read out 0 to 2.5 lakh exempt now, will be exempt in the new scheme also. 2.5 lakhs to 5 lakhs, 5% now will be 5% in the new tax rate. 5 to 7.5 lakhs, 20% now will become 10% in the new rate. 7.5 to 10 lakhs, 20% now will be 15% in the new. 10 to 12.5 lakhs, 30% now will now come to 20%. 12.5 to 15 lakhs, 30% now, 25% in the new rate. Above 15 continues at 30%. In the new tax regime, sir, substantial tax benefit will accrue to a taxpayer depending upon the exemptions and deductions claimed by him. For example, just to make it clear, for example, a person earning 15 lakh of rupees in a year and not availing any deductions whatsoever will pay 1,95,000 as compared to 2,73,000 that he is paying now in the old regime. So this, his tax burden shall be reduced by 78,000 rupees. That will be the reduction in the tax that he has to otherwise pay. Then this is the example of somebody who earns 15 lakhs. He would still be a gainer. He would still be a gainer in the new regime, even if he was taking deduction of 1.5 lakh under various sections of Chapter 6A of the Income Tax Act under the old regime. The new tax regime, sir, shall be optional for taxpayers. So there's no compulsion. Those who want to be in the old regime can continue to be in the old regime, in the old rates, in the whole sets of exemptions and deductions. But those who wish to come into the new are welcome to come into the new. An individual who is currently availing more deductions and exemptions under the Income Tax Act may choose to avail them and continue to pay the tax in the old regime. A new personal tax income rate, income tax rates will entail estimated revenue foregone of 40,000 crores per year. We have also initiated measures to pre-fill income tax return so that an individual who opts for the new regime would need no assistance from an expert to file his return and pay income tax. Sir, I will have to put this observation here. In order to simplify income tax system, I have reviewed all the exemptions and deductions which got incorporated in the income tax legislation over the past several decades. In fact, I have that list with me, sir. I have reviewed all the exemptions and deductions which got incorporated in the income tax legislation over the past several decades. It was surprising to know that currently more than 100 exemptions and deductions of different nature are provided in the Income Tax Act. No wonder the code is like this, the book. I have removed around 70 of them. In the new simplified regime. We will review and rationalize the remaining exemptions and deductions in the coming years with a view to further simplifying the tax system and lowering tax rates. Sir, the dividend distribution tax. Currently, companies are required to pay dividend distribution tax on the dividend paid to its shareholders at the rate of 15% plus applicable surcharge and cess in addition to the tax payable by the company on its profits. It has been argued that the system of levying DDT results in increase in tax burden for investors and especially those who are liable to pay tax less than the rate of DDT if the dividend income is included in their income. Further, non-availability of credit of DDT to most of the foreign investors in their home country results in reduction of rate of return on equity capital for them. In order to increase the attractiveness of the Indian equity market and to provide relief to a large class of investors, I propose to remove the DDT and adopt the classical system of dividend distribution tax, under which companies would not be required to pay DDT. The dividend shall be taxed only in the hands of the recipients at their applicable rates. Further, in order to remove the cascading effect, I also propose to allow deduction for the dividend received by holding company from its subsidiary. The removal of DDT will lead to estimated annual revenue foregone of 25,000 crores. This is another bold move, sir, which will further make India an attractive destination for investment. Sir, a concessional rate for electricity generation companies. In order to give boost to the manufacturing sector, new provisions were introduced in September 2019, offering a concessional corporate tax rate of 15% to the newly incorporated domestic companies in the manufacturing sector, which start manufacturing by March 31, 2023, the corporate rate cut, which happened in September. In order to attract investment in power sector, I propose to extend the concessional corporate tax rate cut to down to 15% to new domestic companies engaged in the generation of electricity as well. So that corporate rate, which came down to 15% for the new manufacturing companies, will now be available even for power generation companies too. So tax concession for foreign investments. In order to incentivize the investment by foreign sovereign wealth funds of foreign governments in the priority sector, I propose to grant 100% tax exemption to their interest, dividend and capital gains income in respect of investment made in infrastructure and other notified sectors before 31st March 2024 with a minimum lock-in period of 3 years. Honourable Speaker, sir, in order to make available foreign funds at lower cost, I propose to extend the period of concessional withholding rate of 5% under Section 194LC for interest payment to non-residents in respect of monies borrowed and bonds issued up to 30th June 2023. I also propose to extend the period up to 30th June 2023 for lower rate of withholding of 5% under Section 194 LD for interest payment to foreign portfolio investors and qualified foreign investors in respect of bonds issued by Indian companies and government securities. I further propose to extend the concessional rate of withholding of 5% under Section 194 LD to the interest payment made on the municipal bonds. In order to incentivize listing of bonds at IFSC exchange, I propose to further reduce the withholding rate from 5% to 4% on interest payment on the bonds listed on its exchanges. Startups have emerged as an engine of growth for our economy. Over the past year, our government has taken several measures to handhold them and support their growth. During their formative years, startups generally use Employee Stock Option Plan, the ESOP, to attract and retain highly talented employees. ESOP is a significant component of compensation for these employees. Currently, ESOPs are taxable as perquisites at the time of exercise. This leads to cash flow problem for the employees who do not sell the shares immediately and continue to hold the same for long term. In order to give a boost to the startup ecosystem, I propose to ease the burden of taxation on the employees by deferring the tax payment by 5 years or till they leave the company or when they sell their shares, whichever is earliest. Further, an eligible startup having turnover of up to 25 crores is allowed a deduction of 100%